Alright, what's up YouTube? Mustang Matt here again, and today I'm bringing you a brand new video. I wanted to give you guys a little video of my thoughts on driving the car with the 302 in her still. And so I'm gonna go for a drive today. I got a few errands to run, basically, and gonna give you guys my thoughts on the car and basically how it drives with the 302 before we pull the motor out and swap it to the 6.0. So here we go, and stay tuned. The e-brake doesn't hold, that's one thing. Flex in it now. picked up this car was when I learned how to drive a manual. I drove it home the very first day. So since then, I've basically been learning how to drive stick. And with the new car, I'm not sure, but I might be going to a automatic slash manual transmission with a racing style shifter and a trans brake and all that stuff. So I'm not too sure yet, but that's probably the route I'm gonna go. But other than that, the subframe connectors really help, and racing seats help a lot too, keep you in on the shoulders, because this thing right now, you can take turns pretty quick if you want, roundabouts and whatnot. But obviously, once I put the skinny tires on and the drag suspension and the drag tires, you're not going to be able to take turns quite as fast, which isn't a whole big deal to me. But that's something I'll be able to test too and see how it is compared to this one. It's really soft and floaty with the stock suspension, and the steering has a lot of unwanted movement playing it. And I'll have to see how it compares, because we're going to a manual steering rack instead of, obviously, power steering. I've never driven a car without power steering, so we'll see how it is. Here's some roundabouts coming up. Transforms, and I know it's gonna be sweet, so I hope you guys guys enjoyed this style of video, and if you want to see more when I get the new car, just leave a comment down below, and thanks for watching.